how's it going? So do you guys remember when I said this? This is an old 2012 MacBook Pro. This thing's about ready to die. That's actually the next thing to get upgraded in here because it's on its way out. Well, that day is finally here. Oh my God. I have been dreaming about owning one of these for like 2-3 years now. Finally, I finally have one. Oh my God, I can't wait to open this box. I don't want to talk anymore. I'm opening this. Even the box is beautiful. This is a 27-inch iMac, fully spec'd, every possible upgrade you can stick into this thing. So excited right now. You have no idea. Look at my face. Like I said, I've been dreaming about this for like 3 years, ever since I started this whole YouTube journey and, you know, stepping up to 4K cameras and getting better at video editing, throwing more effects and crazy stuff in there, and then getting into photography and design and Photoshop and all the stuff that I'm throwing at that little MacBook Pro that I got. Nowadays, it just doesn't want to do it anymore. And I got to be able to step up my game for the business and for this channel and for everything else. So it was time to finally step up to the big dog. So yeah, this is going to definitely step up my game in all of those departments and make me a lot more efficient, make things go a lot faster, especially the video editing part, because video editing for me usually takes like, it's almost like half to a whole day a lot of the time. And most of the time I'm sitting there waiting for things to render and do whatever. And now with this, I don't think I'm gonna be doing much waiting anymore. Now, because I do all that stuff, in reality, I should have stepped up and got the iMac Pro, but the price difference, I don't know if you've looked at how much those cost. It's a lot. This was already a lot. I'm gonna be fully transparent with you right now that this machine, it was dollars Canadian. It's a lot of money. And the iMac Pro, the next step was about $12,000. And I don't know about you, I don't feel like spending $12,000 on a computer anytime soon. This was already bad enough. I swear to God, my butthole is still hurting from it, and it's gonna hurt for a little while. But I don't care, because I know what this is gonna do for my videos and do for my business, and it's gonna be totally 100% worth it. I'm gonna shut up, because I really want to open this box. God, it's so freaking beautiful. And I already know you PC fanboys are in the comments right now typing something, oh, you could have built a PC for half the price. You can save it, all right? As far as operating system, nobody's touching Mac in that department. And there's the amazing device integration if you're using Apple products, so no contest there. You only really got us on two things. One is gaming. I don't really give a shit about gaming. I play Xbox every once in a while. Otherwise, computers are for work for me. And then, of course, there's the price. I'm not gonna argue that one. These things are insane expensive. And sure, I could have built a PC to the same hardware spec and it'd do the same thing for half the price. But then again, a minivan and a Ferrari both do the same thing, and which one would you rather have? So I guess what's next is I gotta clear off this friggin' disaster. Oh, my desk is horrible. I think I am gonna get rid of my dual monitor setup for now. It kind of sucks. I do like having dual monitors, but these things side by side with that new one, it makes this look like a 1993 tube TV. It's horrible. And I've never seen another monitor on the market that looks even half as good as that thing. So until Apple makes another proprietary monitor for me, I'm gonna be rocking a single. But I did hear that's supposed to happen sometime this year, so fingers crossed, give it to me, Apple. I need my duals back. Now the real challenge, can I make cleaning a desk look at least 10% cool on video? Cinematic slider selfie. Well, I'm set up already. I got all my software onto this thing. I got all the files and stuff I need out of this one onto this one. Set up all the drivers and equipment that needs to be run off this thing. It was the most painless process ever. I seriously got the whole thing done in like an hour, hour and a half. I thought this was gonna be an all-night thing. I don't know what to do now. I guess that means I can officially retire the little MacBook Pro. This thing's had a long run and it's not like in life anymore. I don't know if you can tell, but the battery is so swollen in this thing that the whole top side of this thing is convexed out now. The keyboard and the trackpad do not work. The bottom access panel, it's blown out a bunch of the screws on the bottom, and it's pushed the panel open so far that there's so much crap getting inside this computer now. It's just full of dust bunnies and gross stuff, and now it's overheating and all that, which obviously those two things are connected. It's just been running horribly, horribly bad. The more that I throw at this thing, the worse it's getting. And now that I'm making more video content and, you know, doing a lot of photography and a lot of design stuff, it's just, it's had enough. This thing does look pretty rough, but I have had it for 7 years. And anyone who knows me knows that I can break things probably better than anybody. And me and technology, ooh, that's a difficult relationship because those are probably the things that I break the most. And the fact that I've had this thing for 7 years and I've had zero issues with it is really actually amazing and a real testament to how good these actually are. I mean, the only problem I've ever had is the battery, and batteries like this do have a lifespan of around 5 years maximum before they're garbage and they start swelling up and turning into a piece of crap like this one has here. But otherwise, this thing has been perfect. And the reason why it stayed in this condition for so long is the fact that my businesses rely 100% on a computer being running, and this being my only one means that it cannot be unplugged, it cannot be turned off, it cannot be taken to a shop at any point in time. I did get the parts to fix this thing, but I couldn't risk taking it apart and fixing it myself in case anything went wrong until I got this new one. So now that I got this new one here, this little baby is gonna get some love and refreshed back to nearly new status. And as I said that, you know, it just hit me that this thing does deserve to get refreshed and get a second chance, because it might just be a computer to some people, but I owe a lot of what I have going on to this thing. I just realized, like, this hold some sentimental value to me. Up until like 3-4 years ago, I really wasn't a computer guy. I didn't know jack shit about them. I barely knew how to operate them. I definitely didn't know any of the stuff that I know how to do now. And then one day I decided I wanted to make a YouTube video, and the first video that I made for YouTube came from this thing. And everything I've got going on today has snowballed from that. Like, every video I've made up until this point has come from this computer. I learned how to design stuff on this computer, which means my brand started on this computer, and everything it's ever done up to this point has started here somehow. And with my new company, Rogue Lab, all the ideas started here, and every bit of work that has come through the shop so far has started here somehow before it went onto the print floor. So yeah, I've never really realized it, but everything that's happened in the last 3 years, like, this has kind of been the backbone of it. And you know, I owe a lot to this thing. You know, that's really cool. That's something that never even really crossed my mind until I took it off my desk and I'm holding in my hands here now that all of a sudden it hit me. So that makes me really happy that I got all the parts to fix this thing up and make it all new again, because it deserves it. I just gotta find the time to do it now. But man, I'm so pumped on this new setup, you have no idea. I honestly don't even think I'm gonna miss the dual monitors. I say that now until I start operating like 3 programs at once and have to jump back and forth between them. Then I'm probably gonna start missing them again. But for right now, my desk looks so clean and uncluttered. Oh, it feels good, I don't know. And those other monitors won't go to waste either, because I do have that one PC out there for running the ink mixing software, and it will come into play later when I get an embroidery machine, because it'll run the digitizing software. So instead of operating off that tiny little laptop screen, I'm gonna hook one of those bad boys up to it, and that'll fix that problem. And the other one's gonna turn into a little gaming station type of thing. It hasn't happened in like 6 months or so because I've been so insanely busy, but every once in a while I do jump on Twitch and play a little bit of Xbox, and I think if I make myself a little setup where I've got a little monitor and Xbox and all the stuff just set up ready to go, where I just turn it on and go, I might be able to do that a little bit more often. So I'm gonna turn that into a little gaming station somewhere upstairs in my house at some point in time when I get the time to do it. So even though this massive upgrade happened, nothing's going to waste. But man, I can't wait to see how much this steps up my game and pretty much every aspect of what I'm doing right now. First of all, it's gonna make me edit videos like an insane amount faster, so I'm very excited for that. And now that I have something that has the power to do it, I wanna start kind of messing around with motion graphics and a few other little things that can spice these videos up and make them better, because I have had a certain editing style for a decent amount of time now, and now to me it's starting to get a little boring and stale, so I gotta figure out a way to take it from here and bring it up here. And then of course there's the design stuff in Illustrator and Photoshop. Usually I run those 2 programs simultaneously at all times because I jump back and forth between them so much. And now I've got something that has the RAM to handle that without locking up or slowing down or whatever. My workflow around here is gonna just obviously get incredibly faster. So yeah, this is gonna step up productivity huge. It's gonna step up the creativity and hopefully step up the talent level a little bit now that I can kind of branch out and do some other things that my old computer couldn't do. So I think that's gonna be it for this one. I mainly just wanted to make this video because, well, I was super excited for one, because I've been dreaming about this for years, and two, so that I had something to edit to test out how well it does. And I hope this didn't come across as some kind of weird flex of success or status or something stupid like that. I know some people might think that. Trust me, that's definitely not the case here, and that's not the way I roll. I think that shit is dumb as hell. This is more so the fact that I'm documenting my life as a small business owner, and the fact that both of my companies rely hugely on this machine, and that I've been dreaming about having this sitting on my desk for the last 3 years. I feel like it's kind of important to that storyline. And if you don't think it is, well, these are my videos. I get to make whatever I want, so fucking kick rocks. Make sure you guys click all the stuff down below. Follow me on Instagram. We'll see you again in the next one.